Hello, my name is Charles Che, and welcome to my talk, Reimagining the Emacs User Experience with Casual Suite. Casual Suite is a set of opinionated user interfaces to different modes offered in Emacs. But before I get into describing Casual in detail, let's first talk about the existing Emacs user experience. To make Emacs go, people can either invoke commands by name with execute extended command, run a command directly with a pre-assigned key binding, finally use a mouse menu if it's available. From human-computer interface research, there is a concept of recall versus recognition in user interface design. Let's show their distinction by example. A common recall interface is password entry. Absent any historical affordances, a user must directly remember information to succeed with this interface. In contrast, menus offer immediate visual cues on what commands are available. This allows a user to recognize familiar behavior to support successful selection of it. From user interface research, the key finding is this: interfaces emphasizing recognition are much easier to use than those relying on recall. In this light, we see that the Emacs user experience leans too much towards recall. Completion and history can help tip the scales towards recognition, but only by a little bit. This reliance on recall is discouraging to users both new and old, and that's a shame because Emacs has so many useful commands. But the kicker is that most of them are infrequently used. You can't recall them all. At least I can't. So, a conundrum. While I've been using Emacs since the early 90s, truthfully, it's been only in this past decade that I've leveled up in using it. Org mode, Magit, Eglot, Avi, and many other packages have transformed how I use it. I can only deal with so much cognitive load and physically straining key bindings. So, what to do about it? Let's bring back an old ideal. Keyboard-driven menus have been around since TTY video terminals with mainframes. If you're old enough to recall working with such interfaces, these terms will seem familiar. They all worked with the limitations of text-based video displays. With keyboard-driven menus, if a command exists but nobody can find it, it's not really useful. A well-designed menu can make a command discoverable. If the command is infrequently used, making it recognizable helps a lot. And for working primarily with text, having keyboard-only interactions encourages flow. Given the above, the next step seemed natural. Augment Emacs with keyboard-driven menus. This is not saying that I want to obsolete named commands, key bindings, and mouse menus. They all can happily coexist. Emacs is large. It can contain multitudes. Conveniently, Emacs has a built-in library for building such menus. It's called Transient, and it's been around since Emacs 28. Developed primarily by Jonas Bernoulli as a UI toolkit for Magit, Transient has an essential feature for building great keyboard-driven interfaces. A Transient menu can be pinned, and their state updated as commands are issued from them. This lets us build interfaces that reflect internal state changes made by commands issued from the user. This is great because many modes have stateful behavior, and guess what? Emacs has a lot of modes. If you think about it, Emacs modes are akin to the ecosystem of apps that we see today, but with far less structure and packaging. A mode, like an app, focuses on delivering specific behavior to the user. There are many built-in modes in Emacs, and these modes are complex with dozens, if not hundreds, of commands. Calc itself has over 1,000 of them. It's frustrating to know that these commands are there, but I really can't access them via recall. So I decided to do something about it. and that was to transient all the modes, or at least the most major ones. This past summer, I had the time and resources to start building transient interfaces for modes that I wanted to more elegantly use. I decided to call this work casual. Given its definition, it seemed like a good fit for the vibe that I wanted these interfaces to embody. Design principles that I embraced up front were handcrafted information architecture and layout. This is largely an exercise in mapping a mode's command set to a hierarchical menu structure. I wanted these menus to make sense to most people. Ideally, users would not have to read documentation to get at the command that they wanted. Early on, I quickly learned that it was impossible to maintain the existing default key bindings when mapping them over to a hierarchical menu. Also, some bindings I just flat out disagreed with. So I resolved to be friendly, but not beholden to them. In all of the above, I've gone out of my way to make clear that my design decisions are opinionated. Using casual. To reinforce habit, a common key binding is used per mode to raise a main menu. This key binding is left to user preference. For me, that binding is Ctrl-O. Command bindings are anonymic when possible. Mode-specific settings are given their own menu. Since transient menus can be pinned, we can support repeat or stateful behavior in a mode. As of this writing, there are 11 modes supported by casual, with several more on the way. Let's look at the casual menu for DurEd to highlight the design conventions previously mentioned. In a DurEd Emacs window, the user can invoke their preferred key binding to call a top-level casual main menu. This main menu is displayed at the bottom of the Emacs frame. Zooming into this menu, we see the commands offered in it categorized into different sections. Each command has a key binding, usually a single character shown before its label. The file section holds commands that act upon the currently selected item or marked items. The directory section holds commands that affect the current directory or its subdirs within it. The mark section has marking commands that allow for aggregate operations. The navigation section shows commands that move the point in a DurEd buffer. The quick section provides access to bookmark and buffer list commands. Search and replace commands are grouped in the search section. New directory and file creation are given their own section. Finally, at the bottom of the menu are commands dedicated to casual menu navigation. Casual is conformant to transient conventions where the key binding Ctrl-G for dismiss one and Ctrl-Q to dismiss all menus are honored. Another transient convention is to reserve the key binding Q to quit the current mode. For most main menus, casual uses the comma key binding to invoke a mode-specific settings menu. Casual also adopts the common UI convention of using ellipsis and greater than symbols to denote required input and submenus, respectively. Some commands are more global or non-mode specific in nature. A great deal of these commands relate to editing, which I find to be a prime motivation for using Emacs. Let's examine one such menu that supports this. The main menu for Casual EditKit is designed to provide easy access to editing and editing-related commands. Like the previous DurEd menu, it organizes commands into different sections. Commands related to file and buffer operations are in the File section. Commands for editing text are in the Edit section. S or Balanced Expression commands are given a dedicated section for their own. More often than not, in many modes, I find them to do what I want. The Tools section provides access to common tools. Bookmarks I consider to be an essential feature. If you haven't used them, it's never too late to start. Emacs window management commands are given a section. Commands for search and replace, macros, and projects can be accessed from here. Finally, the menu navigation section. Note that register commands can be accessed from here. Okay, enough screenshots. Let's look at Casual in action with a demo of the EditKit menus. So let's start our demo of Casual EditKit with raising the menu, which is bound to Control-O. You'll see the menu pop up here, and in particular, we want to look at the edit operation. So we'll press E, and we'll see a number of menu items that allow you to make editing transformations to the text, be it marking, copying, killing, transposing, transforming, moving, or deleting the text. You'll see also that there's a submenu for rectangle operations. And let's actually dig through and look at what's in the mark submenu. And you'll see that there are increments of text in which you can mark. You can mark a word, a sentence, a paragraph, and balance expression. If we go back, you'll see a similar pattern for copying, as well as killing and transposing. Let's go and try to move a sentence. We have the point there at hello there, and we'll move that sentence around. If we press S, we can move it backward or forward. In this case, let's move it forward. So we'll press F, and you'll see hello there, move up a sentence. And then we can also press B to move it back. And then press return to dismiss. Also, if we wanted to, we can, in this menu particularly, you'll see that we also have cursor navigation, so we can move the point there. That's not in all the menus, but in a good part number of the menus in Casual EditKit, you'll see that here. Let's press return to dismiss that. And let's actually look at some rectangle operations here. In this case, we have a list with items X, Y, and Z. And let's say we wanted to prefix each item here with a string. And we'll say, we want to put in there hello. So one way of doing that is to make a rectangle. And so if we go into our rectangle menu, first off, what we need to do is define that rectangle region. So we'll press M to mark where the point is right there. And then we can use our cursor operation to move the point to define the rectangle. In this case, it's right at the start there. We can use the string insert command, I, to insert hello, colon, and then we'll put a space there to make it look a little nicer. And sure enough, that's in there. And we can have access to a number of rectangle commands here. So if we wanted to, let's say, number, we can go through that same operation here, define a region, a rectangle region that is, and press N, and you'll see that it has incremented a number for each item in that rectangle region. We can also press U, cap U to undo these operations, and leave that at that. Sorting. If we select a region here, and we go back, you'll see that the sort submenu is now enabled. Sorting won't work unless you have a region started, so that's one of the nice things about Transient is that it allows you to visually enable or disable command items with regards to whatever the current state or context is here. And in this case is whether or not you have a region highlighted. And let's say we want to sort these two columns of numbers. And so there's a command called n here, which is numeric fields. And let's choose that here. And sure enough, we get that. But there's a nice twist there. If let's say we wanted to sort on the second column. So let's move our point back up to here. And we'll mark that. And since everything is in a continuous line, we can sort of pretend that this region is actually a paragraph and mark that. And we'll go and select our sort routine. But now we need to figure out how to make numeric fields sort on the second column. So in transient, if we press a question mark, that gives us basically a intermediate help section where if we press a key binding, it will tell us or load the doc string for the command that's there. And so that command in this case is sort numeric fields. And it requires an argument, and that argument can be passed using the prefix argument control U. So press Q and let's do that. In this case, we want to check or use the value 2 and press N, and sure enough, that region is sorted with respect to the second column. Before Casual, so many powerful Emacs commands were not available to me because they were too hard to recall or I could not discover them. Making Casual has changed that, letting me reimagine more positively my user experience with Emacs. If you're interested in any of what I've shown today, I invite you to try out Casual. Before I leave, my thanks and acknowledgements go out to the following people. First, to Jonas Bernoulli for making Transient and Magit. Casual would not be possible without your work. Next, to Psionic K for writing Transient Showcase. It showed me how I could build Casual. To all the Casual users and their support, I am genuinely appreciative. And finally, to John Snader for writing the kind posts on Casual on the iReal website. Thank you. Casual can be found on Melpa, and its repository is hosted on GitHub.